workstation so clean, Jerome?
It's next to godliness. Isn't that what they say?
Godliness. I reviewed your flight plan. Not one error in a million keystrokes. Phenomenal. It's right that someone like you is taking us to Titan.
Has the committee approved the mission? There's been talk of delay.
You shouldn't listen to the talk. You leave in a week. You've got a substance test.
Jerome, never shy, pisses on command.
You have a beautiful piece of equipment there, Jerome. Have I ever told you that?
Only every time I'm in here.
Occupational hazard. I see a great many in the course of any given day. Yours just happens to be an exceptional example. I don't know why my folks didn't order one like that for me. By the way, have I ever told you about my son?
No, you haven't.
Remind me to sometime.
So, we're about to go up. 1 week left. Please tell me you're the least bit excited.
I'll tell you at the end of the week.
Congratulations, Jerome.
Thank you.
How many launches are there in a day? A dozen?
Sometimes more.
You're the only one who watches every one of them. If you're going to pretend like you don't care, don't look up.
The most unremarkable of events. Jerome Morrow, Navigator First Class, is about to embark on a 1-year manned mission to Titan, 14th moon of Saturn. A highly prestigious assignment, although for Jerome, selection was virtually guaranteed at birth. He's blessed with all the gifts required for such an undertaking, a genetic quotient second to none. No, there is truly nothing remarkable about the progress of Jerome Morrow. Except that I am not Jerome Morrow. I was conceived in the Riviera. Not the French Riviera. The Detroit variety. They used to say that a child conceived in love has a greater chance of happiness. They don't say that anymore. I'll never understand what possessed my mother to put her faith in God's hands rather than those of her local geneticist. 10 fingers, 10 toes, that's all that used to matter. Not now. Now, only seconds old, the exact time and cause of my death was already known.
Neurological condition, 60% probability. Manic depression, 42% probability. Attention deficit disorder, 89% probability. Heart disorder, 99% probability. Early fatal potential. Life expectancy, 30.2 years.
30 years.
The name for the certificate?
Anton?
No, Vincent Anton.
Then he'll do something.
Vincent!
From an early age, I came to think of myself as others thought of me.
Vincent!
Chronically ill. Every skinned knee and runny nose was treated as if it were life-threatening.
I'm sorry, the insurance won't cover it. If he fell...
But I was told that everything was...
I really wish there was something I could do.
Like most other parents of their day, they were determined that their next child would be brought into the world in what has become the natural way.
Your extracted eggs, Marie, have been fertilized with Antonio's sperm. After screening, we are left, as you see, with two healthy boys and two very healthy girls. Naturally, no critical predispositions to any of the major inheritable diseases. All that remains is to select the most compatible candidate. First, we may as well decide on gender. Have you given it any thought?
We would want Vincent to have a brother, you know, to play with.
Of course you would. Hello, Vincent. You have specified hazel eyes, dark hair, and fair skin. I have taken the liberty of eradicating any potentially prejudicial conditions. Premature baldness, myopia, alcoholism, and addictive susceptibility, propensity for violence, obesity, etc.
We didn't want... I mean, diseases, yes, but...
Right. We were just wondering if it's good to just leave a few things to chance.
You want to give your child the best possible start. Believe me, we have enough imperfection built in already. Your child doesn't need any additional burdens. And keep in mind, this child is still you. Simply the best of you. You could conceive naturally 1,000 times and never get such a result.
That's how my brother, Anton, came into the world. A son my father considered worthy of his name. By the time we were playing at Blood Brothers, I understood that there was something very different flowing through my veins. And I'd need an awful lot more than a drop if I was going to get anywhere. My goals didn't change a lot in the intervening years.
Vincent.
Much to my parents' dismay.
Vincent. You have to be realistic. With a heart condition like yours.
Mom, there's a chance there's nothing even wrong with my heart.
One chance in 100.
Well, I'll take it, all right?
The trouble is they won't.
Listen. For God's sake, you gotta understand something. The only way that you'll see the inside of a spaceship is if you were cleaning it.
My father was right. It didn't matter how much I lied on my resume. My real resume was in my cells. Why should anybody invest all that money to train me when there are 1,000 other applicants with a far cleaner profile?